detected. You must die now, human.
I've heard stories.
Don't let it fool ya. What if it makes the moon up on high? more than just a light in the sky. If it kisses you and you find you like it, to grab it, it's a man. Each time you pass, owns a car that runs out of gas, then it's time that you get hep. Better watch your step. It's a man. If it acts just like it's the boss, when it knows that you are of course. If it gets a little rough, thinks it's very tough. It's a man. If it walks, if it talks, if its habits are a little bit peculiar, if it brags and tries to make you think it's wonderful, be on the lookout, don't let it fool you. But if it's kneeling down on one knee, saying, darling, please marry me, then don't hesitate, better name the date and then grab it. Hold it.
Disaster which could strike. In addition to many forms of enemy action, there are the dangers of fire, flood, earthquake, and traffic. Knowing what to do before, during, and after a disaster can improve your chances of survival. There is something you can do and do now. You can learn a pattern of survival. Your local office of civil defense is ready to help. Persuade your club, your church, your friends, and your neighbors to help to learn to live. Remember, this is the atomic age. No one can escape its hazards, but everyone can prepare. Listen carefully. What you are about to hear can save your life. Do you know the siren signal in case of atomic attack? Do you know how to find shelter? Do you know how to give first aid? Do you know what will be done for your safety? For further details, consult your local office of civil defense.
Oh, give me your attention. There's been a new invention. It isn't any larger than an adding machine. It's only fair to mention, though it's a new invention. It's one that you have heard about, but you have never seen. It doesn't multiply, and it doesn't multiply. It doesn't touch a bird, it doesn't try to fly. It came about because it made a big atomic bomb. The new invention's clicking, and because the ball is sticking, I know where the idea came from. I tick, tick, tick. Why do I tick?
I want to chit-chat.
I've received word from the castle. Apparently, they've spotted hostiles scouting the perimeter. We should
next
go find out what's going on.
Next person that asked me to shag is getting a well-placed kick.
Minutemen really have what it takes. We've seen a lot of those Institute pro things sniffing around. Looks like they're getting ready to try to take us out. We've called in volunteers, so we aren't short of people. I'm feeling pretty good about our defenses, but it sure wouldn't hurt for you to take a look around and shore up any weak points you see.
Thank you. Come back here, Barrett.
It was a tough fight. I knew the Minutemen were up to the challenge.
Hi, Ronnie.
I guess the Institute will think twice before tangling with the Minutemen again. I hear you're working on figuring out how to hit back at those rats. I hope you find a way, and soon. I'd like another crack at them, with the shoe on the other foot this time. I think Preston wanted to talk to you. Maybe he has some good news.
Time for us to strike back against the Institute.
I have some good news for you. Sturgis found a way into the Institute.
Boy.
We can launch an attack whenever you say the word.
What's this secret way in?
He's been analyzing that data you brought back. Turns out, it included maps of their whole underground complex. He found some old tunnel that's still open to the surface. Cooling water for their reactor, I think. I figured you can get in that way and secure the teleporter, then use it to bring in the rest of our troops. We fight our way to their reactor, fix it to blow, and get the hell out of there.
Do we have enough troops for the assault?
Yes, I think we do now. Enough to fight our way to the reactor, which is all we need. Get the details from Sturgis. I'll make sure the Minutemen are standing by to teleport into the Institute on your signal.
But we don't have time to sit around congratulating ourselves.